Hello, my name is Barry Feigenbaum. Welcome to the Concurrent Programming Made Easy demonstration video. Let's begin with the first demo, which shows many actors of the same type, each of which sends a message to other actors selected at random. The actors send a large number of messages. As we watch the demo, we see that more messages are sent, they can be processed, and many get buffered. Over time, the message send rate slows down, and the buffered messages get processed. Fewer and fewer messages are buffered. Eventually, all message sends stop, and the system comes to a halt. The important thing to notice is that the threads are well utilized as long as the message arrival rate is fairly high. As the arrival rate drops, the thread utilization also drops. While this demo runs, let's discuss the user interface. At the top left is a control panel, which selects the demonstrations to run, and has some controls and meters. The thread bar shows busy threads in green and idle threads in yellow. In the center is the simulation display, which also shows the threads as squares, and the actors as circles. The actors are arranged in a circle with messages between them sent shown as lines. On the right is the trace log showing the time the message is processed, the thread it is on, and the processing event. Actors come in two shades, light when idle and dark when processing a message. Actors can be transparent or opaque. These simulations run until there are no new messages arriving. The simulation then pauses to allow viewing of the log. The second demo is a variant of the classic producer-consumer problem. Each blue producer creates 1 to 3 green consumers and then sends requests to the consumers. Note the message lines have small circles on them that indicate message targets and the number of buffered messages. Note the construction of items in the log. Note the history view at the bottom of the display. Note the numbers next to the thread showing the actor currently running on the thread. Note the use of opaque, then transparent actors. While these simulations run, let's look at the meters. The top meter, messages per second, shows the message arrival rate. The middle meter, dispatches per second, shows the message completion rate. The bottom meter, net message rate, should be near zero over time for a balanced system. Here, the last of the buffered messages are processed. And the simulation halts. The third demo is an implementation of MapReduce. We calculate the sum of the squares of the first 1,000 random number values. That's 100 sets of 10 values each. And then the sets are summed in a reduce process. Finally, the last reduction uses only one thread. Note the result in a trace log. The fourth demo shows a disk scan looking for suspect text files. Each actor processes a message to either scan a directory or scan a file. Processing starts at a root directory and then quickly spreads out, creating actors as directories are processed. Eventually, all the directories and files are scanned, after which execution completes. The last demo is all the above demos running concurrently. Many actors are present and increasing over time. Notice there are many messages and threads are very busy. Under this load, more threads are needed. Some more are added. Even with the additional threads, the threads remain mostly busy for much of this demo. But the message completion rate is increased. And thus, the runtime of this demo is significantly reduced. This demo shows the actor system under a heavy message load and with a large number of actors of different types. Notice the log shows all the various types of messages from the earlier simulations. While not shown, there are controls to enable sounds to indicate thread usage. These sounds indicate transitions from fully busy or fully idle states. These examples show both the flexibility of the actor system and its capability for processing high loads, including support for a variable number of threads and actors. It also makes clear the system's ability to distribute the message load across threads in an efficient and fair way. Thank you for watching this demonstration.